Hey everyone, it's Dave, Display Fireworks 1. A subscriber of mine sent me a video of a homemade firing system that he made. Now, when I'm done talking, I'm going to attach the video that he sent me onto this video, so you'll get a chance to take a look at it. What's interesting about this video that he sent me is he built homemade, you'll get a chance to see, and I believe he's using it this 4th of July holiday. He built essentially what looks like a PyroMagic pinboard firing system. Now I asked him, after he sent it to me, I said, have you ever seen a PyroMagic pinboard firing system? He tells me that he has not. But what's cool is, it's like independently, on his own, he came up with almost the same creation of a PyroMagic pinboard firing system. Now, if you're not familiar with that, I actually have a video of a fireworks display I did using that system. But just to let you know that in this age of wireless firing systems and things, there's still people out there that are doing it the old-fashioned way. And when I told this gentleman about this wireless technology and things, he kind of made a joke. He said, he's a analog man stuck in a digital world. But I think it's kind of cool what he did, and with his permission, I'm posting the video, and it'll give you a chance to check it out. So, without further ado, here's the video that he sent me.
Dave, my name's Dwayne Lottig, and I emailed you several weeks ago about a nail board that I told you I'd built, kind of a little more involved one. I call it a professional one. And I told you I was going to send you an email or a video on it, and here's the video. So here we go. This is a 39 shot board. We use all brass wood screws because of their conductivity. All of our wire connections are soldered in place. Everything we do is for make sure we get good conductivity. You can probably see these LEDs I set in it, and that was kind of a flight of fancy. My theory on that was that it would create enough light to light the board, red color, keep your night vision. The reality is it didn't work. 6 inches or a foot out in front of the thing, you could probably read a book, but the light doesn't cast down, so it does not light it up. So it definitely wasn't worth the time or the expense of doing that, but I've got it. So I guess the least I can say is, and this is my hot wire to the LED lights, the least I can say about it is we have a pretty board at night. But what I do use for illumination, and it's very simple, it's just a battery operated clip-on book light. Have a bracket on top, clip it on, and that gives the board all of the illumination you need. We wire everything as just basic electrical wiring. We use trailer wiring stuff set up on a 12 volt system. I just use a little 12 volt battery, lawnmower battery. I like that better. You can wire two 6 volt flashlight batteries together, but in the long run, you pay $35 for this. You can recharge it, and you've got lots of reservoir there. You've got a lot of supply of power. I put it in one of these boxes and block it in. Just, it's easy for transport. Added a brass neutral rod to it in case I hook two or three things up and I need to hook more than one neutral up, then I've got plenty of space. My firing cable is wired directly to the hot side. It's screwed right on, so we're sure we have a good connection. This is my universal neutral for the whole board, so that's hooked up. my firing cable simply, as you know, you hit your contacts and it fires. However, to speed up the process, so there's not a lag time in the show, we use two people. My wife sits at the firing board, and this is an intermittent switch. It's spring-loaded off, so you have to press it to have contact. And what that does, it's on a long cable wired into this, and I can stand and watch the field and watch racks, and when it's time to fire the next rack, I simply hit the button by visually watching where we're at in the show in the field. And I don't know if you can see it, but there's a little LED light that comes on down in the firing cable, and it just tells my wife, whoever's firing, it's time to touch off the next cue. In the dark, that red LED lights up like a fire truck, and it works well. As I said, the system is wired with trailer equipment, and they're set up in 5Q sequences. So there's 5Qs on a box, and we'll get to the boxes. At some point in time, everything's numbered 1. Well, it's 1 to 13, so forth up to 39. I start at the bottom because I didn't want to be reaching over with a hot contact over live stuff. I figured if I started from the bottom, I'm never reaching over something that has not been fired. And then there will get to be times, as I said, they're set up in 5Q groupings, and I'll explain that more when I get to my field boxes. But if you want to put things out of order, I simply, from what I have the cues numbered, in the sequentially in the show, if you want to switch from different cue groupings, I just cut these little round paper things and number them, and I'll just slip them over it so you can sequence any way you want through the board and customize with those cues. Turning the board around, I'll show you how we set it up. We use 6-wire trailer connectors, and that gives us 5 cues and a common neutral. So here we're set up, this is 1 through 5, 6 through 10, 11 through 15, up to 39, and we'll get to these. These are our 2Q groupings here, and we'll get to that. So what we do for our field boxes, and I'll pull one in here, got a couple here. We simply, this is 6 conductor trailer wire, just a standard 6-point trailer plug. Then we just use PVC boxes that we get from a local home retailer. And they're way deeper than they need to be, but to have the surface area I need, we go with these boxes. They're very good boxes, they're watertight. We connect the wire in with a regular electrical connector. It's a little bit tricky to do that because you got to countersink it because the wall of these boxes are a little thick. They've got a rubber gasket, they're sealed. These are our quick clips, pyro quick clips that you can buy online. And we have 5 Qs, and this is your neutral. It's a common neutral. You could actually get by with just one of these, but these things are sold in pairs, so we put them in. You can see here, we've got numbers on them, and this is for our upcoming 4th of July show. When we wire these boxes, they're all wired uniformly, and we always go low to high, low always starting on the end that the cable goes in at, simply because it's the way you can keep track. But then, so we don't put any numbers on the boxes. A box can be plugged in any point in any one of the plugs, and it'll go low to high. When we set a show up and we know what length of cable we want, because I've got cables from 20 feet to 150 feet, then I'll put them in, and then I'll just put these sticky things on and label them as to which cues they're going to be. And again, this is just 6-conductor trailer wire. It's overkill, but it works for me, and it's a simple system to build if you're not, I'm not a electronics guy. I know basic wiring. I opened this box up just so you could see what the inside looks like. Okay, there's all our cues, 1 through 5, and then you can see how we've got a common neutral. It's just all wired in parallel, and everything's soldered, and then it just goes in like this and gets screwed back on. We've got, as I said, we've got cables from 20 to 150 feet in the trailer wire. Then we also have some 2Q boxes, and what we wire those with is just 14 gauge 3-wire extension cords. We reverse the plugs and put the male plug on the field box, just because it's a little more durable for rough handling than your plug ends. And then these are 100-foot cables, and they just plug in, and you have 2Qs and a common neutral. The beauty of this system, and we the way we wired them, is that if you want to go longer, you can just run in the garage and grab a 3-wire extension cord and plug into it and go out further. A friend of mine had helped me build this. It's an electrician. Said he thinks with the size of wire and stuff, we could go out 500 feet and still have no problem firing things. In fact, I hooked my 150-foot cable up and wired 8 igniters parallel at 150 feet, and it fired them with no problem. We use consumer igniters, Talon igniters. Visually inspect them very good before we hook them up. And I also modify them so I'm more confident that we're going to get 100% ignition with them. And I've been really happy with them. At some later date, if you'd be interested, I'd send you send you a little video on how we modify those to guarantee we get good fire. We can't continuity test with this, but what we do, as I said, we visually inspect the igniters, each one, and I'll hook up here quick. We'll go through before we hook everything up, and we'll test our circuits. So I'm going to just plug in here. Where are we? I'm going into 1 through 5. Okay, so we're plugged in, we're all hooked up. I've got two different highly technical circuit testers. One is just a 12 volt license plate illumination light, and I don't know if I'll be able to do everything myself here or not, but we'll try. So in theory, so we're hooked up to one there, and in theory, there you see, we get light, so we've got a circuit, and we just go down through with one person on the board and manually test all our circuits. I also have one that's an LED light, little red LED light that does the same thing. So that's the system in a nutshell. It's very durable. We're pleased with it. And you can make them from, we have boards we've made for 5Qs to, like I said, this one is our 39Q board. The boxes, field boxes, stretch out into the field, just put varying length cords on them. So you can do what you want. Right now I could, with this board, I've got cables that I could shoot things off at from on the opposing ends of the football field if I wanted to, no problem. We're going to shoot our 4th of July fireworks here in Solon Springs for the community fireworks, all 14G. We're shooting 1,000 mortar shells, and we're shooting 56 500 gram cakes and 24 3-inch 9-shot 500 gram racks. And we're going to fire it all with this board with the 39Qs. We will send you a video of how we set up the display, and also a video of the fireworks themselves. Hope you find this interesting and had a lot of fun doing it. And I guess that's it for today.